Welcome back. You're watching Money, Money, Money. And we are discussing a couple of the important changes introduced in some of the small savings schemes, some of the government-run financial products that the budget has ushered in 2018, in conversation with Kalpesh Ashar. Kalpesh, the other interesting aspect was the changes that are being made to the Vaya Vandana Yojana, a scheme for senior citizens. Now, explain this to us, because first of all, the maximum limit, the investment limit itself has gone up from 7.5 lakhs to 15 lakhs. Is that good news? Does the scheme make sense?
It's absolutely good news, because this was, in fact, introduced in the previous budget with a outside cap of 7.5 lakh rupees. Mm-hmm. And in this budget, they've actually doubled it. Mm. So a 15 lakh rupee per person investment is allowed under Vaya Vandana Yojana.
So your total corpus can't cross. Your total investment in the scheme can't go above 15.
Can't go above 15. Yeah. Now, whether you do it at one shot or whether you do it in parts is a just a matter of choice.
Yeah.
Now, coming to the interest part, it is an 8% guaranteed interest for a tenure of 10 years. Obviously, this product being a pension product is taxable.
Yeah, but that's quite fantastic, because I mean, no other product really, I mean, even including the PPF, as we discussed, everything has become market linked. So, you know, nothing really, even the EPF rate of return every year is determined by the Central Board of Trustees.
Yeah.
So this seems to be a, you know, a critical product which is offering you 8% guaranteed return for the next 10 years.
It is, again, that per person. So if you are a retired senior citizen and you are a couple, you have the option of investing in yours and your wife's name.
Correct.
So you have an actual limit of 30 lakh rupees at 8% per annum, which fetches you 2,40,000 per annum, boiling down to 20,000 rupees per month.
And the investment can start after the age of 60.
Yeah, so your eligibility is 60.
Okay.
And it goes above.
Sure.
So that's not a problem. There's no limit on the outside age part of it. Mm-hmm. Now, the other part of it is here that you can also withdraw this amount during that tenure of 10 years in case of a medical illness you have, or a critical illness, and just add 2% of a penalty or something they impose of that, and you can come out of that amount, out of that account, and put that money for that medical emergency use.
So no lock-in whatsoever at any point, you know, within the first year itself, you can withdraw this money?
Yeah, but the condition has to be the medical condition.
Only under a medical emergency.
Medical emergency. There is obviously a facility of a beneficiary.
Yeah.
Obviously, every product needs to have that. The other part, important one, which we see here is that when you look at it in terms of, you know, the returns on investment, although it is taxable, I think it is still 1% above your bank deposit as on today. And it is like what you rightly said, it's not going to change. So a retired couple can plan their cash flow just by being in this product, which is government guaranteed.
So now here's my question. You know, again, the proponents of, you know, other asset classes and other types of instruments will say, if I'm going to lock in my 15 lakhs, let's say if I, when you retire, you have this kind of corpus, am I better off putting that 15 lakhs in the Vaya Vandana Yojana? Am I better off putting that in debt mutual funds? I'm not going to equity, but if you look at debt itself, then are there other products that you are better off in?
See, Surbhi, this could be a part of your entire portfolio.
Okay.
So when you're doing financial planning or a retirement planning for that particular senior citizens or the couple, I think it could form a part of the corpus. Because here, at least the couple is assured of that much money. Tax notwithstanding. So we have to calculate those things, because debt funds, obviously, we all know that the tax benefit after 3 years seeps in.
Yeah.
So we are not talking about that particularly here. But it lends a lot of comfort that this is guaranteed by the government, and 10 years the interest rate is not going to budge.
That's true. Yeah, you don't have to worry about market conditions.
Exactly. And that would lead to the other product in this, you know, the part of the planning for a senior citizen is a senior citizen savings scheme. Again, a government guaranteed product.
Okay, so do tell us the features of this one as
well. Yeah, so senior citizen savings scheme is under the Small Savings Schemes Act. And in that, you again have a limit of 15 lakh per person.
Okay.
And you can again double it if you are two people.
Yeah.
So you have that limit of 30 lakh again for a couple per se.
Sure.
The rate of interest here is 8.3%.
Okay, so it's 30 basis points higher than what we're getting in the Vaya Vandana.
Exactly. And in Vaya Vandana, the interest payout, you have an option. I think we missed out on that point of getting monthly, quarterly, half yearly, and annual type of a interest payout. And the 8% which is guaranteed is on the monthly. So if you're opting for an annual option, the rate of interest is 8.3.
Okay. Okay.
So that's how it works in the Vaya Vandana.
All right.
That's an option.
Okay.
Now, coming to the senior citizen scheme again, the option here is 8.3%. rate of interest, and the interest payout here is quarterly.
Okay.
Out there.
Okay. So
and it's for a tenure of 5 years.
So there is no monthly option. Interest will be paid out quarterly.
Quarterly, again, taxable.
Okay.
So this again comes under the taxable category. So how?
Which is the same case as the Vai Vandana Yojana
exactly.
as well. Because at the time that you're getting the money back in the form of interest, you will have to pay tax as per your
slab. So here you have another 5 years of tenure, which is extendable by another 3 years.
So it can go up to 8 years.
8 years.
Okay.
So when actually we sit down and do a retirement planning, I think these two products, at least a period of 8 to 10 years is taken care of.
So Kalpesh, the basic question then, both are very similar sounding schemes offering similar rates of return. Which is the better scheme then?
When you say which is a preferred one, in terms of one added advantages, the senior citizen savings scheme gets you a deduction under Section 80C.
Okay.
So obviously, if you are again two people, your at least 1.5 lakh is under Section 80C taken care of.
Absolutely. So yeah, that could be an added tax advantage
exactly,
for sure. But let me now broaden this out. You know, again, if you're looking at, you know, a senior citizen individual or a couple in a metro city, and typically you retire with a sizable corpus, you've got your EPF money, etc. How should you go about sort of breaking this up into different products and maybe even different asset classes? Because the question on everyone's mind is that now I have to plan for the next 20 years. Looking at life expectancy. So how do these government-run schemes then fit in with your overall plan?
I feel, you know, if you have a sizable corpus, then these two schemes, particularly the Vaya Vandana Yojana and the senior citizen savings schemes, actually take a good amount of your fixed income, surely, as a, I would say 30 to 40% of it.
Yeah, if you invest in both.
If you invest in both.
Yeah.
The other part is, as you talk about a broad framework of the portfolio.
Yeah, for a senior citizen.
For a senior citizen. Yeah. The AAA corporate FDs.
Mm-hmm.
Only the AAA.
Right.
And I'm reiterating it. Nothing lesser than that.
Yeah.
Could be another 10-20% of it.
Okay.
And the third part could be a mix of debt and equity.
So perhaps look at a balanced fund or some other hybrid funds.
Equity cannot be ignored.
Okay.
Debt funds cannot be ignored.
Hmm.
So that needs to be first, I think, drilled into the senior citizen's mindset that although these are mutual funds, without them, you will not be able to beat inflation and tax efficient returns.
So let me end this segment by asking you the name of one or two funds. If you were recommending them to your father or, you know, my parents, which would those one or two funds be for senior citizens? Whether it's equity or you know, or a equity debt mix hybrid. Any picks?
Just for the naming part of it for a senior citizen, in the equity hybrid part, I would recommend the ICICI Prudential Balanced Advantage Fund and the HDFC Balanced Fund.
Okay.
And as far as the debt category goes, it always is a challenge, you know, earmarking some funds for them. But I would always be at the shorter end of the curve.
Okay.
And not going for the dynamic bond type of a category.
Since you mentioned corporate debt and high-rated corporate paper, any specific funds, I mean, a lot of these credit opportunity funds that do sort of hold corporate paper, any of those funds that you like?
So the ones which are, I think, having a good amount of AAA and AA to a certain extent, because I would only go for that. I would not look for anything in debt.
And for senior citizens, why would you take the risk?
Absolutely no. It's an absolute no.
Yeah.
And I don't want that alpha in the portfolio for them. If they give me tax-efficient returns, it's more than enough.
True.
Because I've protected the portfolio there by all the other investments which I've made. So in on that count, the Birla Sun Life Short-Term Fund and the Reliance Corporate Bond Fund.
Okay.
So those which come to my mind immediately, I can spell it out.
Okay, great, fantastic. So I think it's all clear for senior citizens. We take a break, but what about the rest of us who are not yet 60? How can we perhaps use the PPF and other instruments and amalgamate these with our portfolios? The conversation continues on the other side.